Stitching and gathering cloth using a needle and thread is another traditional method of patterning cloth. The tight gathers stop the dye entering the cloth in those places. This stitched and gathered cloth will be dyed with imported German chemical dyes bought from the local shop. Ember uses chemical dyes alongside the traditional dyes. Even though they are more expensive, chemical dyes are popular since they give a wide range of brilliant colours and are quick and easy to use. The dye colour is mixed together with caustic soda and sodium dithionite chemicals and then dissolved in a small amount of hot water. The prepared cloth is wetted and concentrated dye is poured on in selected places. With this method, several colours can be applied at one time. Here, three different colours are being used. Another technique is to first dip the whole piece of stitched cloth in dye and then pour on small amounts of concentrated dye of different colours. The dyed cloth is now rinsed and the stitches pulled out, revealing beautiful patterns. Stitched and gathered cloth dyed in this way produces stunning effects. Recently, in the Gambia, an old traditional method of patterning cloth has been revived. Hossi, meaning scratching, is the process where different patterns are scratched or combed onto starch-covered cloth, which is then dyed. This method of patterning cloth dates back to the 19th century. To make the starch, a flour and water paste is boiled in a large can over a wood fire until it is thick. A very small amount of caustic soda is added to the mixture, which then turns a dark brown. The cooked starch is cooled, poured onto the cloth, and then spread out evenly. Wherever you work in the Gambia, you need a background of noise and loud music. A pattern is scratched through the starch paste using a plastic comb made from an old oil container. Different sized combs are used to give different effects. Sticks or fingers can also be used to scratch through the starch paste. The dye will only colour the cloth in the places where the starch has been scraped away. After the patterns have been combed on, the cloth has to be spread out in the sun so that the starch paste can dry properly. The stiff, dry, starched cloth is carefully dipped in the dye. After the cloth has been dyed, the starch is rinsed off, revealing beautiful patterns. Hand-dyed cloth is sold in the market and tourist shops. It is made up into different items like clothes, bags and tablecloths. Cheap, imported ready-made clothes and cloth are becoming increasingly popular in the Gambia and provide strong competition for locally dyed goods. The natural kola nut and indigo dyed cloth is already disappearing since chemical dyes, with their brilliant colours, are so much quicker and easier to use. Fortunately, alongside the local demand, the growing number of tourists in Gambia are helping to keep the local dyed cloth industry alive. Hopefully, the traditional dyed cloth will continue to be made.